So we're at a really interesting homestead. I'm with Whitney. She has such an interesting thing going on here. She has chickens, rabbits. Well, I'm really fascinated with her goats. And she has a soap business that I buy soaps from. And tell me, who's this goat here?
So this is Thor. He is actually our last baby of the spring season and probably the last baby for this year.
Yes.
And he's a Nigerian dwarf goat. So they're a miniature breed, and that's the breed that we're working with right now.
And I heard that this breed works in smaller spaces.
Yes, they're actually great for smaller spaces. There's a 1-acre homestead that I follow on YouTube, and they have Nigerian dwarfs. So
Yeah, it's a popular breed I saw online. And, how many goats do you currently have?
I think I have 5 adults, and then I have these 2 little ones here.
I heard these goats regularly give milk. They're really good for that.
Yes. Yeah, so Nigerian dwarfs are a miniature breed. So you have your standard breeds of goats, which are larger. And so they'll give more milk. Now, they'll give a little bit less milk than a standard breed, but their milk is actually higher in butter fat. So it's great for making cheese, and it's just a lot more creamy than the standard breed's milk, or also even store-bought milk. So.
Oh wow! So yeah, you must be so happy to have these goats around.
Yeah, I mean, they definitely bring a lot of joy.
They do. I was wondering, like, what other benefits goats have to a homestead?
So they're definitely great for weed control. So many people think that goats are grazers, and so grazing is usually on grass, but they're actually browsers. So they actually love herbs and weeds and brush and things like that. So they're really great for clearing out like really woody areas, brushy areas.
And being in South Texas, it's really hot. I see people having goats all the way up north, Canada, here. So what kind of challenges does someone have of having goats here?
So the main challenge that we have here, goats actually prefer cooler weather. Mm-hmm. So that's definitely a challenge here with any animal. It does get pretty hot down here. So that's one of the challenges. And then because down here on the Gulf Coast, we have a more humid climate, dealing with different parasites and managing that is also an issue, because there's like water on the ground a lot, like in the morning dew and things like that.
So there's a lot of responsibility. So like how many hours a week would you say every day, like what do you do?
Every day, it just depends. Obviously, once a month we will trim the goat's hooves, and we'll give them medicine to manage parasites. But most of the time it's just either let them out so that they can browse and graze, and just make sure that their water's clean, and you know, peek out on them, make sure that they're safe.
Yeah.
But at this time right now, I have my goats in the barn right now, because our fence is down. So
I'm wondering about this goat soap business. Yes. That you have. Where can someone buy your goat soaps?
So currently my soap is available on Facebook at Southern Hippie Queen. That's Southern HIPPIE Queen.
Yes, I'll put the link in my video.
Great. Yeah. Yes. That's where you can find me. You can either come and pick up locally here on the farm if you're in the Corpus Christi area, or you can...
Oh, sorry, my son's crying.